Hello, my name is Mike. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to use the Product Information Management work area to understand the many aspects and phases of product data. I'll begin by navigating to the Product Information Management work area. The Product Information Management work area contains infolets that enable me to manage my product information. The work area also shows notifications about events in my workflow that need my attention. In the Product Information Management work area, you can also search for items, catalogs, and so on. Now let's examine a new item request from the Items for Definition infolet. I examine the NIR by clicking the Details tab and deciding on the appropriate action to take. I've examined this, but need to think about it, so I won't take any action just yet. The task list provides me with the tools I need to manage the information lifecycle of product items. Today, I'll begin with Manage Items. For efficiency, the Manage Items page starts with an empty list of items. I'm going to search for the beginning of an item name to produce a list of items matching the name. Now, I'll examine the details of this item. On this page, I can begin to edit or examine the details of the item. Many of an item's attributes are grouped on tabs for convenient access. Now, I'll manage the new item requests to see what new items are in the workflow for product introduction. These are the new item requests that have been assigned to me. The page for viewing the new item request shows its priority and other general information and lists the included new items. Now I want to look at the results of a recent import batch. First, I'll search for a batch. If any items failed import because of errors, they would be shown on the Errors tab. You can export results to a spreadsheet for offline analysis. And now I'll look at the items that were imported successfully. I'm done reviewing this batch, so I'll close the tab. Now I want to use an import map to import item data. First, I'll search for an import map. Now I'll look at the mapping details in the import map. Before I can create a mapping, I must first view the source file details. This map already has the data I want mapped to the required attributes. When I refresh the preview table, it shows how the external data maps onto the master data attributes. I've finished checking on product information for now, so I'll return to the main page. Now that you know the basics, you can explore the other infolets and tasks on your own. Thanks for watching.